It's more business to be decided here. The final semifinal spot is up for grabs. The Men's Cup quarterfinal between New Zealand and Australia. There they come, the Flames. The heat is on, and it really will be on the field. Both of these sides in great form. Fantastic to see that famous black jersey back on the HSBC World Series. Sam Dixon will captain this side. One change of note, Moses Leo out injured. He took an injury in yesterday's last match. The Australians, captained by Nick Maloof, they provided a great moment for Henry Hutchison joining the Century Club. They have a big task on their hands, but they love this battle. Madison Hughes, that's what it's all about.
Absolutely. I mean, there's no game these Australian players will get up for more than this Cup quarterfinal against the New Zealand All Black Seven. So we're set for a cracker here.
You see Rocco Vareni, the Fijian, in charge. Here we go. Australia in the green and gold against New Zealand in the black jerseys. Will be interesting to see. Leo was becoming kind of their impact go-to guy. He will not be available here. Brady Rush gets the start for New Zealand. A couple of players slipping off the top here. They do water this artificial pitch to keep it from burning the player's skin.
Roll away quicker.
The Australians guilty of not rolling away.
New Zealand just going back and back and back there, and after one loose pass like that, sometimes you need one person just to catch the ball and go forward.
McGarvey Black, missing touch. Huge opportunity. Josh Turner rounding midfield. So many weapons in this Australian side. That man, one of them, used to be sort of on his own as a threat.
Seven.
Hit him.
Quick tap for Turner. Loose ball. Snatched up by Sam Dixon. The chest pass out the side. Not much room, but good work
away
from Dylan Collier. That's his job. New Zealand recoiling, looking to come back into the vacated space. Spinning around is Leroy Carter. Lob pass. There's Brady Rush. Oh, he's won the battle. He's bounced out. Brady Rush in full flight down the sideline. Number two for New Zealand. Rush will score.
Brady Rush just saying, get off me. What fantastic play for New Zealand. Interesting stylistically there. Really choosing to keep the ball alive, not take breakdowns. They've got quite a few large players. In previous years, they've often been very confrontational in these wide channels. But choosing to pull out on that left-hand side, move it across, and Brady Rush just brushing off defenders, Tool and Roach, and just having enough pace there to go the distance. Fantastic try from New Zealand.
How good was that to keep the ball away and then give Roach one in the chest?
Yeah, he's done very well. It's for having the ball in the right hand so you know where the defenders are coming from and you can use your limbs to fend them off. Brady Rush, he's tall, he's loose, he's got those long limbs. So you're able to keep the Australian defenders far away from his body.
Well, the history of this match we alluded to off the top. 87th meeting. New Zealand currently holding the recent form record with 10 wins in a row. That kick. Ooh. I think even the touch judge realized they may not have got that one right.
Yeah, looked very close to the touchline, but couldn't really see from our angle, but it will be an Australian tap. That's a mistake from a New Zealand. Uncharacteristic of them to make errors like that, and it gives Australia a chance now to build their way into this game after the first try hasn't gone their way.
And Australia have been in good form this season. Those four quarterfinals, two silvers and a bronze medal in Singapore, and they moved up to second in the table. Of course, New Zealand showing up as 15th. Not available due to some COVID restrictions to some earlier events. So not a fair reflection of the quality, perhaps, but Australia are threatening, and South Africa having been knocked out of the Cup final stage. Tool goes around the corner, sighs through the New Zealand defense. Thinks about one more pass. What has he done? Absolute shocker for Australia. Carter's on the ball, and New Zealand's going to go the other way.
Over.
Advantage over. The ball's in play. Some tired legs out there. Tool's got a chance to make amends. Good pressure and good work downfield for New Zealand.
Cleverly first, please.
It's going to be a high tackle on Nick Maloof. Wow, play on here. Frantic stuff. Australia, a little bit at odds here. Again, Tool wins the battle on the ground. Absolute frustration. They've recoiled full 70 meters from what looked like a sure score to this situation, back to their own 22-meter line.
Away.
Hutchison brought down. Well, credit New Zealand for working back hard, not giving up on the chase. Roach gets through, his arm is free. No one to give it to, though.
Then it was good.
And it's been poached, a fair steal by Brady Rush. Now, New Zealand turning it into attack. Wonderful give and go. Stretching it out. Nashu works so hard in defense, and Nashu gets his try.
What an utterly exhausting passage of play that was. I mean, going back to earlier, Corey Tool had done absolutely exceptional work. He beaten Tony Nashu one-on-one. It looked like he could just amble into the corner, tries to cut it back, and then Australia got the penalty. Their players were exhausted, they were all flat, and yet they tapped and went. That was a mistake. Eventually New Zealand get the turnover, and then it's the same matchup, and Nashu makes no mistake going over in the corner.
Well, Madison, you've been there all those hours on the training pitch doing the extra cardio work. Nashu leaned on it. Look at that exhaustion there. The conversion's lined up, just slides across the front. So New Zealand out of the gates big. Up two tries, but I think the moment of this half has got to be Corey Tool, just for some reason, didn't go for the line.
Corey Tool, I mean, he'd done such exceptional work, and it looked like, yeah, he had the try however he wanted it, but chose to cut inside, and the turnover really cost
over.
Good work there from Matthew Gonzalez. Australia looking for something in the middle. Roach has got out. Oh, the one-hander doesn't go to hand. Probably good for Maloof that ball was deemed to be in touch.
Australia putting themselves in good positions, but then mistakes like that really cost you. Better off just driving your legs, holding the ball. You've got support. Take it down when teammates are around.
Let's form the line up. Let's go.
The one-handed flick in behind. It can really pay off. So if that goes to hand, we might be here saying, what a fantastic offer. But you've got to play the percentages and get them right.
A little bit of contact to the head area there for Roche, but he's up and at it. Of course, these players know what's up for stake. They will be playing Argentina in a cup semifinal at the Canada Sevens. New Zealand previous winners. Australia never lifted the famous First Nations carved cup. Nashu looping around. The hooter sounds. He's still pumping his legs. Good hands from Dixon there. Leroy Carter. A deep pass. Well, there's another interception. Did he get it? No. That's going to be trouble for Australia. If you go for it and you don't get it, Madison, as you know as well as anyone, there's a punishment to be had.
Absolutely. I mean, two moments in this half, Australia will really be ruining. And if those two moments go slightly differently, it's a very different game.
It may not be a bad risk to take being down 10 points against this impressive New Zealand side, but it will make hard work for his teammates. They'll be running time now in the extra time here, and then whatever's left will come off in that second half. New Zealand looking to capitalize on the one-man advantage. They go wide. They'll have talked about the tactics, what the basics are when you find yourselves in this situation, 7-on-6. A little bit deeper on the end to cover that, and they've got their reward. That passes forward. Massive relief for Argentina.
Half-time, guys.
Sorry, Australia. So that'll do it. A frantic first half. New Zealand up 12 points to nil over Australia. Garvey Black to his left. Perfectly weighted kick right on the 10-meter line. Oh, sorry. Take that back. The referee said it didn't travel 10. Glorious opportunity for Australia. Exactly what they want. First half. Benenti talked about taking the inside shoulder. What a crushing tackle.
No.
Dixon crushed him, but then didn't release him. This Australian side are capable of scoring points quickly.
Goal 11.
That man, Nathan Lawson, has got a couple this weekend. He's off the bench, as is that man. The fancy feet, the white dancing boots. Great the opportunity. And Ben Maher gets a try. That is positive play from Australia, and the substitutes, immediate impact.
Maurice Longbottom coming in, having that impact, finding the inside pass. And when you've stepped across the face of two defenders, a third New Zealand defender is flying across, and that fourth New Zealand defender doesn't come. Really impressed by Longbottom, but also Hutchinson. He's pushing the pace. Roach and Toole have gone off for Australia, who've been two of their talismans so far this season. But Hutchinson pushing the pace, saying, hey guys, if we want to win this, we have to go and get it.
Lawson knows they got to get going. He's happy with that. He got a try earlier against Canada. The Wallaby is there, but these are not the Wallabies, of course, because that's the 15-a-side team. This is Australia 7s, who are right back in this match. Although the skipper for New Zealand steps up and says, I'll have some of that. Although both colliding players are not doing that well. The bottom of your screen. Maybe an opportunity. Ben Maher appears to be walking wounded out here on the bottom of your screen, but New Zealand
on.
Off the knee. The second is finally a knock on.
First was off the foot.
Apologies for any language that's slipping in through our effects, Mike. It's a pretty emotional game, Australia, New Zealand.
Yes, some very excited Australians there. This half has started exactly how they wanted to. The first half, they didn't take their chances. This one, they scored that early try, and now they've got the ball back in prime attacking opportunity. And we can see Corey Toole there, who has been their go-to man so far this year, looking to come back, see if he can get back on and make an impact.
A bit of a shift in the momentum. Australia's errors earlier, and now New Zealand with a few errors, a knock-on there. Longbottom, as I said, in the white boots with half a field to work with to the top
straight.
Right of your screen. See here if he goes. Let's see what he finds. Maurice Longbottom stepping in and out. Fantastic defensive positioning from Leroy Carter.
Release. Hands out.
Australia through the hands. Matthew Gonzalez.
Hands out now.
Met immediately from Sam Dixon. Quick show from Lawson. Longbottom deciding to go back the other way. May have been some opportunity up top. That is a speculative pass. Advantage being paid. Off and running. Nick Maloof is in the space. He's 5 meters out. He throws over the top. Just about gets Henry Hutchison. Scoops it up.
Away, tackler Black.
Tackler stuck in there. He's doing his best to get out of there.
The ball's available.
Maher pushes it wide. Ooh, double tackle there. Nathan Lawson sandwiched.
Tackle on the shoulder.
Referee says the shoulder hits up high.
On the mark, please.
And Lawson is down for the moment. Yeah, I'm not sure about that.
Yeah, that's tough. I think the referee was saying there was no wrap, but it looks like he's hit with both arms going on that ball. So for me, that's a fair tackle, but safety issues, they're trying to be overly cautious, perhaps. New Zealand getting the wrong rubber of the green there.
It'll give New Zealand a chance to regroup. 5 points in this match. 3 minutes, 20 to play. Longbottom taps. Australia down by five. Inside the New Zealand 22. Around the corner goes Toole, and he's done it. Corey Toole backs himself in an arcing run. Gives himself his team a chance to take the lead. With the conversion.
Great finish from Corey Toole, making up for the one he missed out on earlier. I mean, he's one-on-one with Regan Ware, who is no slouch. Not many people will go around Regan Ware like that. But Corey Toole showing the pace, getting over the line, and tying with 2.5 minutes left in this match.
Yeah, 12-12 currently. This is for the lead. Well-struck ball. The touch judge has a look. No. So with 2 minutes 30 to play, 12 all. Australia with a big comeback in this second half. Two tries. Toole really has been the danger man. fantastic in Singapore last week as well.
Absolutely. I mean, he's so good at using his footwork to sit the defender down and then his pace to go on the outside. And that's what he did in that one there.
Play on. Malouf up in the air. Outstanding aerial work, as you'd expect. This great footballing nation. Long bottom. Met by Tony Vai. Immediately, he reverses direction. Australia busting through.
Hands out. No, oh, Black. No, Black.
No hands, says the referee. Off the ground. 1 minute, 45 to play. Tool is crushed by Vai.
No, bust the hand. No.
Just enough support for Australia to keep possession. It's 12 all here. 1 minute, 30 to play. Big hits are coming in now, fast and furious. Options for Australia. Henry Hutchison pushes it wide. Maurice Longbottom puts it back to Hutchison. I think it opened up for him. They've got space. Tool out wide. Corey Tool in the corner.
Australia working their way through the phases and finding the man in space. A couple big collisions in the run-up to that. Malouf are involved in those. Just working their way through. Little touch. Hey. The referee just impeding Baker slightly. But Tool having the pace and getting in the corner.
Credit Australia doing the basics well. Right out from the kickoff, their aerial man got the ball back, and then they started the onslaught. Longbottom looking to add the extras. It's a great strike from the sideline. Maurice Longbottom making that advantage 7 points to Australia.
Fantastic kick at a crucial time for Longbottom. You said it, it was real simplicity from Australia that paid off there. And that's what their coach emphasized at halftime. Let's just run hard, carry the ball, and go through some phases.
Fresh legs on the park for New Zealand. They've got the ball. That's job done. What can they do with it? 10 seconds. Must maintain possession. No errors now for New Zealand. They push it wide. There goes the hooter. Running across is Kurt Baker. He wanted it back. He didn't get it, but he's there at the breakdown. And his hands are off. Not much in that, but you can see what it means to the Australian seven side. Kurt Baker can't quite believe the call.
Baker looks baffled, not happy with that call, but just going off his feet, hands going straight to the ground, and that's the visual the referees are looking for. Once they see that body angle and your hands on the ground, and Australia with a famous victory, and they will be so, so pleased with that second half performance especially.
For the first time in 11 attempts, Australia